Hello guys, it's your totally tired boy Edgy Machine here, and this is the first episode of the three parts that I'm going to upload about the new Broken Fang operation. This one is mainly focused on investments and how the market reacted to the new operation, while the other two are going to be a reaction opening and showcase video. Before we get into the video though, I just want to let you guys know that only 10% of you watching are actually subscribed, which is a pretty low number. So please, if you are watching this and you are not subscribed, please do so right now. It would help me out a lot, and with that being said, let's get straight into the video. Today's video is sponsored by CTsider.com. CTsider.com is a platform that is focused on bringing back the old days of trading and a way to connect to the trading community yet again. You can search for trade offers, create your own, or just discuss a trade in the comments section. I know a lot of you guys that are watching this video right now are trying to trade up to their dream items, and I have been asked countless times as to where I can find people to trade with. Well, here's your answer. Simply create a new trade offer by logging in with Steam and then selecting an item from your inventory and the item you want on the right side. You can also search for an existing trade on the top left and find someone who looks for your items. CTsider.com is quick, easy and totally free to use, so go check it out. Link is in the description. Alright, so let's get to the investment part of things. There's something crucially different here this time to all prior operations, which is the system of how you get drops, cases, agents and so on. Instead of it being random drops the further you progress with your level like the last time, Valve has made it so you can basically buy anything you want for the stars that you've gained through doing missions. You can even partially pick exactly what operator you want, or can choose to get a case or a random drop from any of the collections, including the 3 new skin collections, 2 sticker collections, 1 graffiti collection and 1 patch collection. This fundamental change of how you are able to obtain these items is also going to be having a huge impact on their prices during and after the operation. This is mostly visible in the case prices right now, as they are the lowest operation cases have ever been listed after such a short period of time, since people can just buy them with the stars they gained from doing missions. The fact that players can get them so easily will probably also result in a lot more of them being available on the market than usual, which might result in more cases being opened and more items of that case being unboxed than usually during an operation's time period. And since this operation is set to last until the 30th of April, we're going to see a hell lot of cases being unboxed and bought in general, or at least more than the usual, which might result in lower prices for all the items within the case, like the gloves. However, what that means is that the investment potential of the items and gloves afterwards is a lot higher, as many people probably try to dump stuff in the time span of the operation since they are afraid the items will lose in value once the operation is over. However, a lot of this also depends on if the case is going into the normal drop pool after the operation, or if it's going to be discontinued just like the Hydra and Shattered Web cases. If so, the items in their case, and especially the gloves, would still be super limited compared to other items from normal cases. Prices of the cases are probably going to be the lowest by the end of the operation, when the discount is going to take place. Investing can work out very well if the case is discontinued, but that still has some time, and I will probably make a separate video about that shortly before the operation is going to end. But let's go through it step by step. An interesting topping in terms of investments are the agents, which are completely renewed, which means that the Shattered Web agents are officially never obtainable again. Well, apart from buying them on the market, obviously. However, because of the new operators and their hype, people want to get rid of their old operators. It's almost like a panic sale to some degree, which is understandable, I guess, because the new operators do look sick, but a lot of people forget how rare the old ones have become over time and that they are not going to come back ever again. So if you want to invest in old agents, now might be the time, since they eventually will recover with supplies dropping lower and lower. I don't know how far they will drop or for how long, but try to buy at the lowest point possible and watch that investment be very successful in about 1 or 2 years time. Owning an investment of the first operators ever is something special, and I'm sure that this fact alone is going to make them rise in price eventually, with the supply shrinking to a bare minimum. The old agents are pretty much low supply, low demand items now, which might make them take a little longer to go up, but eventually they will do so. Also, a big reason as to why Ava crashed down so much is that she looks exactly like the new female operator, which kinda sucks, I guess, kinda disappointed, but oh well, what can we do? As for the new operators themselves, I do see them actually gaining value quickly after the operation, especially the ones with watches on them, as that is a nice little feature to have in-game that's also visible at all times, which might boost the prices of these once the operation is over and the agent's gone forever. Also, condom head is a very hot take of mine, but like I said, I will make a separate video on those investments later on into the operation. When it comes to cases, we also have a lot of stuff going on. First of all, the glove, hydra and clutch case are all experiencing heavy price drops, since these are the cases that feature the first generation gloves. But because we have the second generation of gloves newly released, a lot of people seem to be afraid that they will lose their value and panic sell, which I can guarantee you they won't. Judging from a lot of different people's opinions online, most of the gloves are actually disliked, and there's only two or three that the community enjoys, or at least that opinion is widely spread, that only 2 to 3 gloves are good looking. So on the long run, I think these cases will recover, so you can also try and invest in them while they are crashing down. Most heavily affected is actually the Hydra case, which lost over 1 euro of its value over just a few hours, which is quite insane. And seeing how limited that case is and how expensive the items in it are, you should definitely invest some money into it if you have some left over. I know it's quite an expensive case, but so are the items within that case. Other cases are not affected yet by the new operation, although I think they might go down a little, but not as drastic as the other cases with gloves. When it comes to investing into the broken Fang case itself, it's really complicated to predict its future, as mentioned before, since we don't know what's going to happen after the operation ends, and if especially the gloves are going to be reintroduced into a new case, which I think they will, as I don't see Valve making new gloves for only one case. I can imagine them doing exactly the same thing they did with the Shattered Web Knights, which they reintroduced as well. In general, I don't see this case going anywhere too quickly, since it's obtainable much easier than the Shattered Web case, which also just crashed after the release of the operation, and apart from a few gloves, doesn't hold the nicest items, or at least, well, that's my opinion. I don't really see the new case going anywhere soon if the gloves are being reintroduced. Moving on to the collections, we again have the problem with a high supply, which wasn't an issue before. In recent operations, you couldn't just get operation drop after operation drop. You had to reach certain levels to get them, or well, buy them. Now you can just play missions all day long and spend all your stars on operation drops, which most people will probably do, as it is the closest we've ever come to opening cases for free if you take the 12.75 euros out of consideration. With such high supply by the end of the operation, I can see some of these collections items be valued lower than similar ones in prior operations. However, this also is a good point for investing, as you can buy way more items, and since they are still very limited compared to normal items, they could still pay off in the end. Again, I will talk about specific items and when to exactly invest in a separate video that will be released by the end of this operation. Since only map unrelated collections have been added, nothing changed in the prices of other normal map collections so far, but I'm still waiting on that new cobblestone collection, Valve, so please make it happen, thank you. Taking a look at the stickers, I think these might be underestimated by a lot of people yet again, just like they were in the Shattered Web operation. The gold web fall, for example, ended up going up quite a lot since it's so limited, and even though the sticker of the Broken Fang are not going to be as rare as the Shattered Web stickers, they are definitely better looking in my opinion. Especially all four holos of the set are super good looking in-game, and can potentially become huge stonks once the operation is over, as I don't see too many people buying these because they are simply not talked about enough. People will probably spend all their stars on the operation drops, as they think this is the best option to get for your stars. So once the operation ends and these are decently priced, I think you could pull some profit because of how rare and actually decent looking they will become. However, I don't see the point in the recall stickers, and I don't think they are going to go up a lot simply because they do not look good by any meaning. But maybe the lack of supply that these stickers will have, since no one buys them, will cause them to spike up all of a sudden, just like it happened to the PGL 2017 golds. Who knows, although I think the safe route here is to go for the normal holos from the Broken Fang collection instead. I'm not going to talk about graffitis and patches for now, I will do that in a separate video sometime soon, as they are a little more complicated to talk about investment wise. Other investments that I've spotted which could potentially end up in profit are the AK-47 Jaguar, which looks like the budget version of the newly released Panthera Onka, and therefore is dropping in price quite heavily, which eventually will recover, but I would give that investment some more time, as lobster prices are still dropping at the moment. Also, the 5-7 cherries and berries is possibly going to ruin the number one blue gem 5-7 prices, as they are available in different patterns and one of them is almost completely blue and much cleaner than the original 5-7 blue gem. So for now, there's no point in buying a P157 pattern. Eventually though, these also will recover, so if you have been looking to buy one of those, now might be the time, with them dropping in price due to the new cherries and berries added. Alright, that's all of it for now. I hope you were able to get some idea of how this operation is going to turn out investment wise, and as always, if you enjoyed the video, leave it a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and with that being said, Edgy Machine out. Oh, and if you have any questions or anything regarding investments about the operation, please let me know in the comment section down below. I'll make sure to answer every single comment, or at least I'll try. So yeah, have a nice weekend, guys. So much I don't really know what it's like. I'm floating in a boat and the tide is rolling by, surely but slowly, and I'm hoping